Hi. In this new tutorial, we will talk about the benefit of using the real zoom in the Vray Frame Buffer in comparison with the regular zoom. Here I have the scene. I will launch the interactive renderer, the IPR. So, if you like to have an idea about some detail in your scene, in your rendering, generally you just using the middle mouse button, you can zoom in. Now, this regular zoom here, it's just making the pixels bigger to give you the impression that you are zooming in. So, in some cases, this might be enough, but if you like to have a better idea about some fine details or some specific effects in your scene, it is better to use the real zoom. Also, there's another benefit from the real zoom, and we will see that later, is that you can check other parts of your scene outside the limits of your perspective viewport or the camera limits. So, to use the real zoom, just right click and click real zoom. Now here, as you can see, when I'm zooming in, the rendering becomes slower, because in the real zoom, what you are doing, you are not using any trick like making the pixels bigger. You are actually getting closer to the geometry. It is like you are taking your camera and you are moving it closer to the geometry, or if you are in a perspective viewport, you can, it's like you are just getting closer to the geometry and rendering. So every time I'm zooming out or panning, it's like in reality, in the scene, I am in this place and there is no pixel enlargement or anything. You're just, so in this case, you can have a better idea about fine details or some specific effects, and you, without the need to really mess up your camera location, or if you are in a perspective viewport and you just like you are working on some area and you don't want to change your point view. Here it's like you are really walking around your scene and rendering. Another benefit of the real zoom is that, for example, here I can using the middle mouse button, I can pan. Now I'm checking out some areas that are not part of my camera view. This thing, you cannot do it in your regular zoom. I can pan, check out some other places in my scene, zoom in on them, and see how they are looking. Of course, I'm not going to wait for the whole rendering to finish, but you get the idea. You can try it on your own and you'll understand. So, to go back to the regular zoom, you can just right click and click turn off the real zoom. When you turn it off, you will get this, because in the regular zoom, you can only see what is your camera is seeing, or what is, or if you are in a perspective viewport, it's you can only see the limits of the area of that you are rendering. So basically, that's it for this video. Hope you like it, and if you do, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you in the next video. Thank you.